Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 73 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 124 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 125 and question 126. Question 125. You create a recovery service vault backup policy named policy 1 as shown in the following exhibit. So let's scroll down and see the entire policy. Policy 1. The backup schedule frequency is on daily basis at 11 p.m. and at UTC time zone. The retention of daily backup point would be for 30 days from the backup. Retention of weekly backup point, which would be happening on Sunday at 11 p.m. for 10 weeks. So it will retain the backup copy which is happening on Sunday at 11 p.m. It would retain it for 10 weeks. So we have first retention policy, which will be for daily backup. Second retention policy, which is for weekly backup. Third retention policy, which is retention of monthly backup point, would be happening on first of the month at 11 p.m. and that would retain for 36 months. So this is the third policy. Retention of yearly backup point, which would be happening on March 1st every year at 11 p.m. and that would retain for 10 years. Four retention policies under this policy 1. Now keep in mind, we have daily backup, we have weekly backup, we have monthly backup, and we have yearly backup. So let's say if there is both the backup are there, let's say if daily is happening definitely every day at 11 p.m., weekly is happening on Sunday, monthly is happening on first of every month, there could be, you know, chances that that could be a Sunday as well, and yearly one is happening on 1st March, which may have Sunday as well. Please keep in mind that less frequent backup would have higher priority to retain. So for example, on the 1st March, the 4th policy retention would trigger. The monthly policy would not apply on that particular backup point. Then for monthly backup, if it is even Sunday, it would apply the 3rd policy, which is the monthly policy. On weekly one, it would not the daily policy would not be applicable. It would apply the weekly one, which is the second retention policy, and the definitely for daily one, it would have the first policy, which would remain for 30 days. Let's go to answer area. Answer area. The backup that occurs on Sunday, March 1, will be retained for. So as we have discussed earlier, that if yearly and monthly retention are occurring on the same time, it means it would prefer the yearly one because it has longer retention period as well as it would have lesser frequent backup. Therefore it would prefer the yearly one, and definitely for yearly backup, we would have 10 years of retention period for that backup. Monthly retention would not be applicable here since the longer retention period is in place. Statement 2. The backup that occurs on Sunday, November 1, will be retained for. So here in the second statement, the first, the monthly, because it's the 1st of November, and the second it would be the weekly one. Weekly retention and monthly retention would apply. Therefore, it would pick the monthly one because it is less frequent and longer retention period. Therefore, monthly will be applicable, not the weekly one. And for the monthly one, retain the backup for 36 months. Let's move to next question. Question 126. You have the Azure virtual machines shown in the following table. VM1, which is in West Europe, VM2, which is in West Europe, VM3, which is in North Europe, and VM4, that is also in North Europe region. You have recovery service vault that protects VM1 and VM2. So the recovery service vault is protecting these two virtual machines. Therefore, that recovery service vault is in West Europe region itself. You need to protect VM3 and VM4, which are in North Europe, by using recovery service. What should you do first? First of all, the recovery service vault must be deployed on the same region as the VM. Therefore, the recovery service vault which is being used by VM1 and VM2 cannot be used by VM3 and VM4 to protect VM3 and VM4. Therefore, we have to have new recovery service vault. So let's see the options available. Create new recovery service vault. Yes, we will have to create new recovery service vault. That's the correct answer. Option B, create a storage account. That is not needed for recovery service. Option C, configure the extensions for VM3 and VM4. That is not needed here. Option D, create a new backup policy. That is also not needed. First, we have to have the recovery service vault. Therefore, answer A is the first action item.
I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you next video.